Dear learner, I welcome you all to today's discussion. Today we will discuss a chapter on motion in a straight line. Earlier we have discussed about the concept of velocity, acceleration, displacement, etc. and the chapter equation of motion. Today only we will concentrate on equation of motion and graph. You can see this ball moving on the table. When a ball moves, you find it at different position at different times. Similarly, the velocity and acceleration is also different at different time. The different position and corresponding times plotted on a graph gives a certain curve, which is known as position time curve. Similarly, you can plot velocity time curve also. Here you have to plot the velocity against the corresponding time, which gives you the velocity time curve. After completing this lesson, you will be able to represent and interpret position time and velocity time graph for uniform as well as non-uniform motion. You will be able to explain terms like instantaneous velocity and average velocity from graph. You will be also able to derive equation of motion with constant acceleration by graphical method. Today we will discuss first representation of motion in graph. So, how to represent motion in a graph? Here you can see a graph paper and a line drawn on the graph paper. Always in case of representation of motion in graph, we take the independent variable along x-axis and the dependent variable along y-axis. Here the independent variable is time and the dependent variable is position in case of position time graph and velocity in case of velocity time graph. So, when we plot the position with the corresponding time, then we get the position time graph. Here we have taken distance along y-axis and time along x-axis. The distance is almost equal to the position. Position means distance of the body from the origin to the particular position at a particular time. So that gives the distance. So here you can see distance time graph. Similarly, if you plot the velocity along with the corresponding time, then that gives you the velocity time graph. So today first we will discuss position time graph for bodies at rest. For bodies at rest, suppose we are taking an example. Here you can see one table where time has been taken as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 seconds, and corresponding positions are taken as 10 at when time equal to t equal to 0 second, again 10 meter when time is 1 second, again 10 meter when time is 2 second, and so on. You can see that the position of the body is at 10 meter when the time is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 second. So we can say that the position is not changing. So the body is at rest. So now we will represent the distance or position of the body with time. So here you can see on the graph that the position of the body has been plotted along with corresponding time, which gives you a straight line graph which is parallel to the time axis. So the position time graph for bodies at rest is a straight line parallel to time axis. Here you might confuse between position time and distance time graph, but both are same. Now we will discuss about position time graph for uniform motion. But now, what is uniform motion? Uniform motion is that motion in which body covers equal distance in equal interval of time. So here you can see on the table the time is taken as 0 second, 10 second, 20 second, 30 second and 40 second. That means the interval is 10 second and the position are 0, 5, 10, 15 and 20 meter. You can see between the equal interval of time, that is 10 second interval, the body is covering equal distance. That is, the distance is in each 10 second, it is covering 5 meter. So it is an example of uniform motion. So here, if we plot a graph of the position or distance covered by the body along with time, then you will get a straight line which is inclined to the time axis. It is also straight line, but it is inclined to time axis. So this is position time graph for uniform motion. Now, what is the position time graph for non-uniform motion? So now you can ask, what is non-uniform motion? You remember that earlier we have discussed what is non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion is that motion in which the body covers on equal distance in equal interval of time. So here in this graph you can see the time has been taken as equal interval, that is 1 second, 1 second, 1 second. But the distance covered is unequal. Hence, the graph obtained will be a continuous curve. Now, we will learn how to interpret position time graph. From the shape of graph, we can tell about the type of motion. So, if the shape of graph is a straight line parallel to time axis, then we can say that the body is at rest. If the shape of graph is straight line inclined to time axis, then the motion is uniform motion as we have seen earlier. If the shape of graph is continuous curve, then the type of motion is non-uniform motion. So this is the shape of graph which tells us about the type of motion. Now we can also calculate velocity from distance time or position time graph. So how to calculate velocity? Actually, the slope of the straight line graph which we obtained from the position time graph, that is equal to the average velocity. So we can say slope of the straight line equal to average velocity. We can denote average velocity as v bar equal to x2 minus x1 divided by t2 minus t1, where x2 is the final position, x1 is initial position, t2 is final time and t1 is initial time. This is equal to delta x divided by delta t. Delta x is the difference of position, delta t is difference in time. So we can say here one inference that greater the value of the slope, more will be the average velocity. If the slope is more, then the average velocity will be more. We can also calculate slope by taking tan theta, where theta is angle between the straight line graph and the time axis. So here in this graph, you can see we have taken an example of average velocity. Here you can calculate average velocity. Average velocity equal to 15 minus 10 divided by 30 minus 20. The red line has been drawn to denote the time and distance. We are calculating the average velocity between the time interval 20 and 30 seconds. So the average velocity comes out to be 5 divided by 10, which is 0.5. meter per second. This is how you can calculate the average velocity from distance time or position time graph. Now, from position time graph, we can also calculate instantaneous velocity. The velocity of a particle at any instant of time is called its instantaneous velocity. When delta t is made smaller and smaller, average velocity approaches instantaneous velocity. For non-uniform motion, when the delta t is made smaller, limit delta t tends to 0, del x by del t equal to dx by dt, which gives you the instantaneous velocity. Now, we will study about velocity time graph. Here you can see the velocity time graph for uniform motion and non-uniform motion. In case of uniform motion, you can see the velocity time graph is a straight line, which is parallel to time axis. So we can say that the velocity remains constant with time. So you can find one straight line graph which is parallel to time axis. But in case of non-uniform motion, the velocity time graph is a straight line which is inclined to time axis. When the body is moving with non-uniform motion, its acceleration might be constant or its acceleration might be variable. So, for constant acceleration or uniform acceleration, the velocity time graph is a straight line. Here you can see the velocity time graph for uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration. So, you can see for uniform acceleration, the velocity time graph is a straight line which is inclined to the time axis. But in case of non-uniform acceleration, you can find the velocity time graph is a curve. In the earlier, we have studied about or we have seen the velocity time graph for uniform motion and non-uniform motion. In case of non-uniform motion, we have seen that the velocity time graph was a straight line which is inclined to time axis, but in that case it was for uniform acceleration. Here also the first graph is velocity time graph for uniform acceleration, but the second one is velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration. Now we will interpret the velocity time graph. We can determine the distance traveled by the body from the velocity time graph. Here you can see one velocity time graph for uniform acceleration. So the graph is a straight line inclined to time axis. So we can find out the distance traveled by the body by the area under the curve or graph we have obtained. Here we have obtained one straight line graph. So if you find out the area under this straight line graph, then that will give you the distance traveled by the body in that particular time interval, that is here 0 to t. So we can determine the distance traveled by the body from velocity time graph. We can also determine the acceleration from velocity time graph. Here the average acceleration equal to v2 minus v1 divided by t2 minus t1, where v2 is final velocity, v1 is initial velocity, t2 is final time and t1 is initial time. So this is equal to del v divided by del t, where del v is difference in velocity or change in velocity and del t is change in time. If slope is constant, we can say that average acceleration is constant, which happens in case of bodies moving with uniform acceleration. But in case of non-uniform acceleration, acceleration we can find out by limit delta t tends to 0 del v by del t, which is equal to dv by dt, and again this is equal to the slope of the tangent drawn to the curve at that time. If we draw a tangent to the graph or to the curve obtained, then that slope of the tangent gives us the acceleration in case of non-uniform acceleration. So this is how we obtained or we learned how to calculate the distance traveled or how to find out the acceleration from velocity time graph and how to draw graph. Now we will discuss about the equations of motion. How to find out the equation of motion from the graph and where we can use that equation of motion. So first we will study about the first equation of motion. Here you can see one velocity time graph for uniform acceleration. Actually we find out the equation of motion taking the acceleration to be uniform. In all the three cases we will study about three equations of motion, and all the three cases we will take that or we will assume that the acceleration is uniform. So in this case the initial velocity is suppose u, final velocity is v and time is t, acceleration a and displacement s. We can find out the acceleration as rate of change of velocity. We can write a equal to v minus u divided by t meter per second square. So a into t equal to v minus u, hence we can write v equal to u plus at meter per second, as the unit of velocity is meter per second. So in case of first equation of motion, we find out the final velocity when we know about the initial velocity, acceleration and time. The first equation of motion is v, that is final velocity, equal to u, initial velocity, plus acceleration into time. Now we will discuss second equation of motion. In case of second equation of motion, we find out the displacement if initial velocity, time and acceleration are known. Here also we take initial velocity as u, final velocity as v, time t, acceleration a and displacement s. So in this case we find out displacement. Earlier we have discussed that displacement can be calculated from velocity time graph as area under the graph. If we find out the area under the graph obtained, then that will give us the displacement. So here we will find out the area under the graph represented by the black line. Here the area under the graph or this black line is colored. So this colored area is a triangle and a rectangle. So if you find out the area of this triangle and this rectangle and you add both the area, then that will give you the displacement. Hence we can write S equal to area of rectangle plus area of triangle. This is equal to area of rectangle you can find out U into T plus area of triangle equal to half T into V minus U. S equal to you can write UT plus half T into V minus U. But you know that from first equation of motion V minus U by T equal to A, that is acceleration. So we can write V minus U equal to A into T. If we put this value in the above equation, we can find out S equal to UT plus half AT square. So S equal to UT plus half AT square. This is how you can find out displacement from this velocity time graph. And this is the second equation of motion. Now, how to find out third equation of motion from velocity time graph? Actually, third equation of motion is not an independent equation. It can be found out from the first and second equation of motion. Here also, we find or we calculate displacement when we know the acceleration, the initial velocity and the final velocity. Now, we have to find out displacement, and again, we will use the same concept, that is displacement equal to area under the line. Here also, you can find out the velocity time graph is a straight line because we have taken the acceleration to be uniform, and we have to find out the area under this black line or the graph. So the area under the graph is colored as blue and yellow, but you can see that this total area is the area of a trapezium. If you put the formula for area of trapezium, that is the half of addition of the two parallel line into height. If you put this formula, then you can find out S equal to half U plus B into T, because the height is equal to T. Now, you can find out T equal to, as you know, V minus U divided by A. So, we can write S equal to half U plus B into V minus U by A. In place of T, we can put V minus U by A. So, this is equal to half V square minus U square divided by A, as V plus U into V minus U equal to V square minus U square. Hence, S equal to half V square minus U square divided by A. This can be written as 2As equal to V square minus U square. Or you can write V square equal to U square plus 2As. So, this is how you can find out the displacement if V, U and A are known to you. So, this is how you can find out the three equations of motion from the graph. Now, let us summarize what we have discussed today. The position time graph for a body at rest is a straight line parallel to the time axis. The position time graph for uniform motion is a straight line inclined to the time axis. The velocity of a particle at any instant of time or at any point of its path is called instantaneous velocity. The slope of the position time graph gives the average velocity. The velocity time graph for a body moving with constant acceleration is a straight line inclined to the time axis. The area under the velocity time graph gives the displacement of the body. The average acceleration of the body can be computed by the slope of velocity time graph. I hope you have understood what we have discussed today. Wishing you all the best. Thank you.
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हैं। हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने। जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने। कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय के लोच से युक्त हो,
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय के लोच से युक्त हो।
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे, ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने।
राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें। अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं, जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।
क्या आप जानते हैं एक ऐसा शिक्षा संस्थान जो दे आपकी उम्मीदों को नई ऊंचाई। क्या आप जानते हैं एक ऐसा शिक्षा संस्थान जो दे आपको घर बैठे जब चाहे तब एडमिशन की सुविधा। क्या आप जानते हैं एक ऐसा शिक्षा संस्थान जो आपको दे तकनीकी क्षेत्र में आगे बढ़ने का मौका। अगर आप नहीं जानते तो NIOS। जी हाँ, NIOS मात्र एक ऐसा शिक्षा संस्थान जो दे आपके जीवन को उज्जवल भविष्य और सुगम राह। 25 लाख शिक्षार्थियों ने किया भरोसा इस शिक्षा संस्थान पर और किए आगे बढ़ने के मजबूत इरादे। जो देगा आपको घर बैठे शिक्षण सामग्री के साथ रेडियो व टेलीविजन कार्यक्रमों का सहयोग।
अरे वाह, ऐसा सुनहरा अवसर और कहा।
अब होगा सबका सपना साकार।
यकीन नहीं होता अब शिक्षित होना होगा इतना आसान।